chapter in portfolio management and stuff. What I did think was interesting was there's the Investment Banking Institute. They provide scholarships. It sounds like a pretty good boot camp, modeling, creation, dilution, giving the whole M&A, and then you walk away. I don't know how expensive it is. Templates. Basically, get trained in investment banking, which I thought was pretty cool. So, you may want to look into it. I would say this, along with the CFA, the Global Association of Risk Professionals, or CARP, they do a certification in risk management also. And then I think now it's, I think it's Columbia or Georgetown does the MS in global financial analysis and analytics. So you're starting to see, you know, this. You got the CFA that's already set up. And then you're seeing certifications in risk management. Here's some more. You can get. And I've seen,
well, I'm going.
I've seen some people, master's degrees, MBA, top school, CFA, certification, risk management. Pretty amazing backgrounds. They work for pension funds and, you know, investment advisory firms. We have two portfolios with people like Wells Fargo, Frontier, Georgia. If that's something you guys are interested in, you should tell me. So I can start gearing you, you know, towards that direction. Okay. Andrew, what's happening? Okay, you need to come see me about your memos. And then about the pitch book and the printouts.
Okay.
And once everybody gets here, I'll go through kind of the global schedule. Here's a, if you want to come see me, I would say come see me so I can take a look at your notes. Come see me so I can take a look at your notes. Come see me so I can take a look at your notes. So I need the five asset class memos so that everybody's done them, so I can design the trading, the second phase of that thing. And then I need for you to look at me and tell me that you can print out the three scenarios that you can print out the three packets. Okay, the static portfolio approach with the memo that basically tells me the performance. Okay, sell it to me as a static portfolio, give me another memo, do the active with the backup information. I don't need a lot of information, just the memo. It describes the portfolio, describes the performance and the risk. And then the hybrid, the target portfolio. And then from those three, once those three are done, then we can roll those in to the report and start doing the, you know, the report. The report doesn't need to be long because you got all the backup information. But I need you to put together the report. And my concern is that it'll happen as we start to get towards the end of the semester, since I've been here over 3.5 years. People start to go MIA on. And then they don't, you know, show up, and I don't see them until the end of the semester, right? Until they start panicking to get all the work done. So now they're competing against their other three classes, where I'm giving you plenty of time to work on this thing with me to try to get it so you're front-loading your work so that you have more time on the back end, because I'm not giving you exams in the class. So I was hoping that you would take some of that time and front-load the reports so we could focus on the reports and the homework, and really not have to do anything other than that by the end of the semester, and then just work on the problems for the book. Mm-hmm. I think it's plenty of material. So I don't want to have to add in more stuff because I'm not seeing, you know, not seeing any content. Does that make sense? So if I'm not seeing anything, then I got to do something for me to learn the material. Mm-hmm. Okay. So is everybody clear on that? Now, Jacques's not here. He was working on, isn't Jacques on your team?
My team?
No.
No, he's in Dakota.
Yeah, did he finish the memo?
No, not all of it.
Okay.
Well,
he's probably the first, he's not only doing the memo, but he's also doing like the outline of the report, isn't he?
Yeah, so we did, yeah, we just outlined it on a dock.
Yeah, exactly.
And then we're just putting.
Piece of sections, yeah, which is awesome. So you're gonna need a cover page, the abstract, you might wanna write these things down or type them in. For the report, you're gonna need the cover page, okay, and then you need an abstract to write up. I'll leave it on this thing. Cause we gotta start thinking about the report now. So the first thing I need is the, is portfolio one. And I need the memo. And you need to work with the old memo so that you know what the memo should look like. Instead of just handing me in the memo and then thinking that that's gonna pass muster. Cause again, you can't show this stuff to anybody if you just give it to me and it's not formatted correctly. Like the memos in 123, people are coming back to me a year later and saying, you know, the memos are really good and somebody talked to me, sent me an email or LinkedIn this morning and said, you know, thank you very much for, you know, last semester, and now that I've graduated, I'm really prepared for the real world, and I have no fears, I just missed eight terms. So she was prepared. Okay, so a lot of the stuff we do is preparation. So portfolio one, I need that memo. Okay, and actually the memo goes on the front. And this is, the next one is gonna be portfolio number one printouts. So it's pretty, it should be pretty straightforward if you know how to print out. I don't need all the stuff underneath the tables.
Is that first?
This is the first one.
That first memo, is that the first memo for the first portfolio?
Yeah.
Or is that the full?
Yeah. No, because I wanna break them up. I wanna break them up into individual products.
Yeah.
And then I wanna combine them into a hybrid. Okay, so everything should roll up. Once we do three, then we roll them up and consolidate them into a final consolidated report, but you can mark these, show these to people individually. And then portfolio two, then the memo two. Right, and this one's your static. This is your active. Right. This is gonna be the portfolio number two, all the back tests. All the back and forth tests. And go back, you know, go back 10 years if you can. If your results are not working out for you compared to the S&P 500, you may have to go back 10 years, but our institutional investors are investing in these portfolios for 10, 20, 30 years. So you're capturing the cycle. If you go the up cycle in 1 year, 3 years, 5 years gets a tail of the down, right, with the up, and then the 10, you got one full cycle. And if you can outperform the benchmark by 100, 200 basis points on a 10-year, you're in, because that's what we look at at the end of the day. And then the target. Is everybody clear?
So
is everybody clear?
Mm-hmm. So the memo is the proposal that we were talking about with like all those charts and stuff.
Yeah, it's gonna be, you know, the date, it's gonna be to me, from you, and it's gonna be proposed static portfolio product.
Do you want?
Is the RE. And you're gonna tell me a little bit about it. It should be that first paragraph should be the mission statement, right? That you had on that first page. Then you're gonna give me the performance of the portfolio, which is next, and then you're gonna hit me again, okay?
Are we writing that out, or can we like?
You type it out.
Lay it out, like, but I'm saying, do you want those like another paragraph, or can we like line it up like in a table, like?
Yeah, this will be the table right here. this is basically this like we did before.
Okay.
So this is gonna be the table, you know, of a performance. The return on the portfolio going back 1, 3, 5, 10 years, and maybe a forward test. And if you do a forward test, you need to annualize the data. You need to annualize it. Right, so where are we now? When did we start the class? Late August?
September.
If you wanted to say like first front test, or like you start on September 1st.
September 1st, so September, October, November, so October. So we only have 2 months of return, 2, 4, 6, 8, 12. Take the 2 months, multiply it by 5, you get an annualized. Does that make sense?
Two by six.
You're saying the full returns when we look
at
the
forward,
at the end.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, the forward test, you only have 2 months.
Yeah.
Right? So if you do annualized, that's right. So it's the 2 months return times 6 to get an annualized run rate. It's not going to be very accurate. You're going to have to call it this. It's an estimated annualized. And you have to do it against the S&P 500 terms.
Okay.
But you see what I'm saying? Everything's annualized.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Everybody?
Yeah.
Does that make sense? Yeah. How to do run rates? Everybody knows how to do run rates?
No.
Run rates?
No.
Run rates. If I have 2 months of return, I multiply it by 6, I get annualized. Right? If I have 6 months of return, I multiply it by 2. Exactly. Does that make sense? So what you're doing is you're doing a run rate, your projection. Okay? But you got to qualify and tell them about. So the memo, 8, 2, from, it actually, it should be to the GTC investment team. It should be the GTC investment committee. And then this is your team, right?
So we have days, horizontal, hurry, and manage
here.
Margins.
Whatever your static.
Make everything 0.5. Mm-hmm. And then I center on page horizontally and vertically in front of the middle.
Okay, so
then what I do is I save this as a PDF.
Static portfolio product. Do you have a name? Do you have a brand new name for your portfolio? For your group? Do you have a name? Just doing some portfolio stuff to the class, and it really doesn't matter. You got to brand it. You got to come up with a name. You got to sell it. Okay. There's no such thing as analysts. You're salespeople. You're just really smart at being able to develop new product. You got to be able to sell the product. You got to come up with a brand, and you got to sell it. So maybe it's called DTC Static Portfolio Product or something. Make something up. But come up with a product name. It's like, and then you have the thesis statement, right? Which is your mission statement. Our portfolio is a static portfolio that's outperformed the market consistently over the last 10 years. It's made up mainly of high-tech companies, large cap in growth, medical, and hardware space. The expected return over the 10-year time horizon is 14.5% with moderate risk. We anticipate the growth of the portfolio to reach $6 billion under management within the next 3 to 5 years, and total fees at 1% of, you know, $600 million, whatever the math is. That's what we care about. Okay? So you tell us that right off the bat, then you show us the performance. You know, back-tested and forward-tested against the S&P 500 with the alpha, and maybe a weighted average beta. Boom, that's all I care about. Okay? Boom, right? That's all we care about. And then what I'll do, or what we'll do, is this will go on top of the spreadsheets. That's all we do as the board, is we read the memo, we flip through the spreadsheets to make sure that they're accurate. You know, that the alphas look right, the returns look reasonable, that the allocations look correct. You know, just to check and audit to make sure that they're correct. Boom, staple it, you're done. That's the staff. then you just replicate the same thing, you back test, forward test for the actual location based off your optimization. So you're having, actually you have two sets of tables for that one. Because not only do you have your back test, forward test tables, but you also have the backup data from the quadratic optimization that you did. So this one is going to even be more, going to be thicker. But you don't have to put any of the analysis into the memo. We don't care about that. We just care about the results. But I want to see the printouts so I can audit them to make sure that they're correct. And I need to look at your spreadsheets to make sure that you didn't make any mistakes, particularly when you copied and pasted the results from the iteration box over into the iterations and over and basically copied over some of the formulas. Okay, so I got to check and make sure the formulas are reading right. Okay.
So when you put like the back forward testing on that, that's just a printout of the spreadsheet.
That's just a printout of the spreadsheet. And I don't need everything underneath the spreadsheets with all the notes that I've printed out.
Just
I just
the
want the results.
Yeah.
All the results. Okay, and then you have to go ahead and you have to do a reconciliation, right, between the two to basically come up with your target. Also with your min max allocations for the stocks. Some of you want to have a minimum of 1%, or probably not 2%, a minimum of at least 1% allocation to the portfolios that got zero in the active. And you're going to reconcile the two, and you're going to reconcile the information that you know about the individual companies to come up with a target allocation. Are you following? Okay. Once you get the target allocation, then you save down the file again, and you basically do the back and the forward testing. Okay. And then the final report is going to be the combination. It's going to be a memo. It's probably going to be a two-page memo. But it's going to be a combination of, right? You're going to probably put the third memo actually should just be the target.
So you can go view that.
Right, the target portfolio.
So you're done with it.
But the total report I probably would want to see. On the memo, here's the performance of the static. Here's the performance of the target. With your recommendations. That makes sense. So quickly, right off the bat, when I look at the final report memo, I'm focusing directly on your target allocation results. And then I can compare them against the static and the active to say, yep, this is it. This is the one that's going to, that's the one we can bring to you. These are basically just product development. We're just testing the product here. Right? This is the final product that we're going to sell right here.
Manager?
Yeah.
Okay. And I would probably do a footnote. On these. Also, on this final memo. We'd probably do a footnote. Right here or down here at the bottom of the page, telling us that you've also implemented a moving average crossover system, a trading system to enhance the global portfolio.
Because we're badasses? Or what?
Yeah, totally. Okay. Yeah, and I would even probably put in down here at the bottom, right? Sneak in with the yield enhancement you were able to create, the value you were able to create in conjunction with this. So not only were you able to get a 13% rate of return or 150 basis points over the S&P 500, but you were able to generate another $300,000 on a million. Well,
yeah.
Your portfolio is going to be a billion, what's $300,000 times 3,000.
A lot.
Yeah, that's a lot. So, you want to mention what you did on the moving average crossover as a yield enhancement to the target core portfolio. Now we're talking about some serious money. And you're getting people interested. Okay. And if you show this stuff to anybody, which actually you probably shouldn't, because our intellectual, this is our IP, right? So you want to be probably careful with it, seriously. Because you've developed this stuff, it's worth money, all right? And people will steal your stuff and take it and then leave you out on the street. So you probably want to show them when you're talking to them, if they're serious. You show them the memo and maybe you show a high level results. You don't give them the back data, the full report, unless they hire you. Okay. I'll show you the total results, but let's talk about the internship. Let's talk about the job. Okay. See if you can nail them down. Okay. Because again, as you start to move up in your careers and start developing these value techniques, you become extremely valuable and people will steal your stuff. Because why would they hire you when they can just steal your stuff? Just show me the report. Show me the report. Where'd you get the data? How did you calculate that? Walk me through that. Seriously. Totally serious. That's how they
know.
Okay. All right. So Alfred's not here. Dakota, give me an update on where you are on your report. Are you the leader of the team?
Yeah, we're making those. Well, we were making the bigger memo, but we can break it down and make the smaller memos.
Yeah, that should be straightforward. Yeah, if you do the full two-page memo, then you just edit it down to the registrar.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Just got together our active weights, so we're gonna run it through the moving average.
And I did look at the active weight, the optimization, right? And kind of signed off on it.
Yeah.
Okay. So put the packages together, throw the memos together on the front, and then give it to me so I can audit it.
Cool.
Okay. And then Evan?
Yeah.
Are you the team lead on that?
No, he is.
Okay.
Nice.
You're all action leaders.
Well, I mean, yeah.
Okay.
I'm not gonna.
That's okay. I mean, you guys all have to be leaders on this. Mm-hmm. Naki, give me an update.
So we're all done.
This is basically the Monday morning meeting, okay? This is how we do it. We go over the progress of all of the projects with the individual team leads so we can get an assessment so we can move forward so that we can reach the milestone dates that we've basically set out for ourselves so that we can hit the delivery dates, okay?
All done with the static.
And I audited that?
Yeah, I think so, yes.
Yeah, I probably want to take a look at it again. Okay. And then who's writing your memo for you? Okay, I would designate something. Okay, go ahead. What about the active?
Probably then with your help.
Okay. And then you can't do the target until you get the
target.
Okay, but you can do you can start setting up the memo. Okay, and then Connor's not here. Got it. Gabriel.
We're working on active right now. We're designating.
Okay, wait, what about the static?
Static's already done.
Okay, did you print it out again without all the stuff at the bottom? And then will you give me a memo?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay,
so, and then tell me about the active.
Okay,
what's the problem? Is it just time or is it complexity? So you got the data in there, you got your returns, your ALICO variance, you estimated the expected returns for 2018?
Yeah.
Are you done with
that? Yeah.
Okay. So now you're working through the iterations?
Yeah.
Okay.
Then you want to be
creating the actual.
Okay. I would designate somebody to start on the memos.
Okay.
Desmond, you're in. Got it. Riley, give me an update on your guys.
We're all team effort on the memo. They're in charge of more of the analytical stuff. I have all the tech stuff.
So you got the static, and that didn't do that well. So did you do the active?
Yeah.
And then what was the performance on that? Compared to the benchmark?
Let me check it.
Riley, you're doing the memo?
I don't know.
We're all inputting our information that we gather.
For the 5 year, it was 387 basis point, 387 basis point.
Oh, that you beat on the active?
Yeah. 3 year was 852 basis points, and then the 1 year was 156.
Okay. And then you guys you solved the problem about the moving average crossover stuff, having to rely on that. You basically restructured your portfolio to be able to get the performance that you needed to appeal to the investors. Got it. Okay. And then who's going to do the moving average crossovers?
For our group?
All of them.
Riley's doing it.
I got all the tech stuff.
Okay. And then what was the performance on that?
I'm still working on the active one.
Okay. And you're the technical analyst on that?
Yeah. I have all the technical stuff.
And then Ivan, was anybody coming up to you and asking you for help on the moving crossover? Yeah, make sure that they're taking care of it. Okay, I'll do it too, but you're the lead on that one. Okay. And then Andrew, you're with them. Okay, so you're the lead on that. And then Kent, give me an update on you and Connor, and give me an update on your static.
I think static is almost done. Just Connor has to input one final part, and then it's finalized.
Oh, yeah, you guys are having problems.
Yeah.
Okay, don't forget to start on the memo.
Okay.
And then have you started on the active?
Yeah, we just started on it.
Okay, work with Riley, Ben, Matt, maybe even Sean, or James. Those guys seem to have it down, too. So accelerate the process now.
Got it.
Try to do everything yourself anymore.
Got it.
Okay, you need a team at this point. And then you're going to do the target. And once people start giving me stuff, I'll start making it available to bring everybody up. Okay. So we're all producing at the same level of quality. I can't have different levels of quality. Okay. Can't have different levels of quality reports. Right. They all have to be produced at the same level. Okay. And then Doc's taken care of. And then Ben, that was Riley. Ivan, how are you guys doing? You're with Mike, aren't you?
I'm with
just Ben.
Oh yeah, Alfred's, he's in pretty good shape. So just make sure he didn't get hit by a car or, you know, in an airline accident. He'd be kind of messed up. He's like one of the top guys. Seriously, he's like one of the top students. He didn't even take one 23. And he's like acing everything. It's pretty amazing.
Priority?
And Sean and Mike, give me an update on your static. Didn't we already look at that?
Yeah.
So I just need the printouts and the memos.
Yep.
Okay, and then you're working through the active.
We just have to do our capital allocation line. The graph got messed up.
Oh, that's right.
So we're just going to copy everything. Like during the
class. So you guys are ready to do the target.
Yeah.
Like in the memos behind that.
Yep.
And then did you guys test the Anaki? Did you do the moving average crossover yet?
No,
the moving average crossover system is totally separate.
The earliest one, the 10:30 with now.
Yeah. The moving average crossover.
First time of the 0% that has zero shares.
Do you guys?
Ricardo? Matt's taking care of James. Everything going on okay on your side. James, are you the technician?
I'm with these guys.
Yeah, but who's the technician?
I think we're all technicians.
Okay. And then who's the fundamentalist?
I think we're. I don't know.
We're all are you done with fundamental analysis?
No.
Okay, is anybody done with fundamental analysis?
That's like financial ratios and intrinsic values and whatnot. Yeah, we're done with that.
Okay. Anybody else built the, what was that, a couple months ago that we did that? A month ago?
What?
Then we put together the fundamental securities analysis to be able to run the intrinsic valuations to come up with premiums and discounts.
Yeah.
No? I only heard one team say
yes. Yeah, yep. We use EBITDA and...
So that's fine. I'm not worried about the matrix. I'm just having done conducted the fundamental securities analysis.
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else? Okay. If I don't hear anything, that means that.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Just working on it.
Yeah. Same thing.
You may want to work with some of the teams that are involved. Okay. So that you can this PFL process.
What are you talking about? The ratios and the intrinsic valuations?
Yeah. The intrinsic valuations, the models.
She did.
Did you guys do the intrinsic valuations? If you did the intrinsic valuations, you would have got the numbers in your forecast for the 2018.
That might not.
You didn't do anything with that, using the means of the unions. Am I speaking too fast for you guys? You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then Brendan, are you also? Questions about securities analysis, or any optimization, or do you print out the static portfolios, or are you working on the memos? And what are you working on? Are you telling these guys what to do? You should start producing the documentation. Yeah, the three, not the memos for the market analysis, but the memos for the business. Get that stuff. But the format's the same.
The format's the same,
but the reason you're selling me a portfolio, it's the same thing. Okay, you have the thesis
here,
basically the table in the middle, and the
table. How did they figure out
the portfolio against the
that's a technical issue where they can't figure out how to when we set up the gen term, they were like, everyone after 2 p.m. can bunch in their class for sign up time. Now we don't know how to do it.
Maybe it's just
maybe there's too many people in it. Whatever.
It doesn't matter, right? It just helps us.
Yeah, true.
As long as, you know.
Don't ask, don't tell.
I didn't do
it.
Yeah.